Good morning, everybody. My last job of the day. It's about almost 7 o'clock. Creeping in on it, doing some upholstery where some red soda has spilled on it. So I'm going to show you here. I'm down to my last cushion. It's a bad one. You can see all that. That's not clean yet. That's just scrub. Letting the pre-spray. And believe it or not, I'm actually using a very light mixture of Soap Daddy's Primetime Enzyme in here. And it's breaking. You can see the red and everything liquefying. Get into the soap here. So it's doing a really good job, actually. The last one wasn't that bad. It was bad, but not this bad. So this is the worst one. Normally I have my tool, my, what do you call that thing? My table. I don't have my table with me today. I left it at the house. And I went home early too, or in between jobs. But I just forgot to get it. Look at that.
Just keep it still here.
Love this fabric. This couch, or this the whole couch, I think she said, well, it's been here as long as I can remember, cleaning it. And my dad been cleaning this house for before he retired, and yeah, long time. I'm gonna go over it dry because I have a feeling some might bleed back up, so I may have to go over it a couple more times, like right there. See a little bit coming back. See, that's why it's important when doing furniture. Do a lot of dry passes because that'll bleed back up later. It'll look good and it'll bleed back later when you leave. So you got to make sure you do a ton of dry passes and you don't see anything. Because when you're doing the dry passes and it comes out to be completely dry, you can be confident at that point that nothing's gonna bleed back because the fabric's already dry. Look at that. I'm gonna take a picture real quick. Okay, I'm back. hope you enjoyed that quick little video.
Alright.
Can't remember what the other side looks like. Oh.
Just as bad.
Well, we'll finish it up and with this here, flip it and finish it and get it back to the client.